Hey guys, State of Play just featured roughly 20 minutes of Ghost of Tsushima gameplay in the way of a huge info dump showing off some of the exploration, combat, crafting, and other features in the game. As I expected, this is shaping to be a really interesting game, which actually seems to be going for several different, almost opposite objectives at the same time. There's an artistic pitch here with a muted HUD trying to showcase as much of the world with as little obstruction as possible, while some of the other elements shown feel very gamey and almost detrimental to that first objective. So let's go over what they showed off. First of all, it seems like they're trying to go for a Breath of the Wild style approach to the exploration. They even mentioned looking out for strange looking trees or pillars of smoke. But again, this seems to be sidelined a bit by the existence of map markers that clearly indicate locations that you haven't explored yet. This isn't necessarily a bad thing. I think it can actually be really smart to go for a best of both worlds style approach, where you get some clearly defined objectives, but there's also a bunch of hidden stuff to explore. In Breath of the Wild, the sole focus of the game is the exploration. The story is almost laughably bad and not at all the reason that you're playing, but here it's pretty clear that the exploration isn't the focus, but rather just a part of the journey. I'm a huge fan of what they've done with the waypoint system. You can use the wind to guide you towards your objective, which is absolute genius, and it's one of those things where you wonder why other games haven't used that before, because it seems so obvious once you think about it. Animals like foxes and birds can also guide you towards secrets and collectibles, and Breath of the Wild actually had a very similar thing where dogs would sometimes do that, but here it seems to be much more deliberate and obvious. But that's, again, not necessarily something bad. The wind thing reminds me a bit of Shadow of the Colossus, where you could use the sword to bounce off the sun's light and use it to guide you to your next objective. It's a really cool idea that uses the environment instead of your screen to tell you where to go, which is really subtle. It seems here like they aren't really innovating so much as taking inspiration from some of the best ideas that are already present in games like this. I mentioned earlier that even though these systems allow you to get rid of the HUD and focus on the environment to provide a more immersive experience, there's also a bunch of things that seem slightly out of place. The crafting system, for instance. They didn't really show it in the trailer other than mentioning that you can collect flowers to change the color of your armor, but it seems like anything you can collect glows with a white light that I'm not a huge fan of. If they're trying to go for this whole artistic style, we don't need a HUD type of game, having something like that feels very gamey, and I think it takes away from that experience. There's obviously a better way to do it, since games like The Witcher 3 let you collect a wide variety of plants without having them glow all the time. That's one of the complaints that I have with what they've shown so far. The other has to do with the combat system, so let's talk about that. They've shown two styles of combat, the Samurai and the Ghost. Based on their previous work with Infamous, where you could choose between the Righteous Path and the Villain side, basically, it seems like you'll choose between the two styles and advance and unlock skills the more you use them, so focusing on one style could be really beneficial. The Samurai is your dueler, the straightforward approach of just walking into an enemy camp and taking everybody head on. Heavy armor, hard-hitting attacks, and the ability to combo finishers to take down several enemies at once. The Ghost, which is obviously the stealth-based approach, seems to play a little bit like Assassin's Creed, where even if you get caught, there's still plenty of options available for you to deal with your enemies. Even the smoke bomb seems to work exactly like it does in those games. The thing that worries me about the combat is that it seems kinda clunky. There's one thing specifically that's been bothering me since I saw it, and it's the way that the slash goes completely through this guy's shield. The shield basically disappears and reappears behind him, which, you know, is not the way shields work. I'd be fine if the slash destroyed the shield, but there seems to be a complete lack of interaction, and that worries me. It seems like it would be very important to get the hit detection for weapons right for the slow and deliberate style of combat that they seem to be going for. So seeing a shield get completely bypassed makes me worry a bit. Other than that, the combat system seems to feature a parry and dodge mechanic, and it's neat to see that you can parry arrows, because if you've played Witcher 3, you know how annoying they can be. So the combat system seems to be focused on simple, decisive strikes rather than just mashing your way through. I really like the parry mechanic in games, so this seems right up my alley, and I like the absence of supernatural elements, at least so far. It seems like everything is fairly grounded. The ghost style, which is probably the style I would choose because I play stealthy archer in every RPG whenever possible, seems really cool. There's a grapple hook, which appears to be restricted to very specific use cases, and several different takedown maneuvers, which can even cause surrounding enemies to cower in fear, which is pretty awesome. I think the way they showed it in this gameplay preview is really well done, and better than I've seen in other games, like for example Shadow of Mordor. The fact that they drop to the ground and try and crawl away while not being able to really take their eyes off you works really well, I think. They showed off a bit of the customization and gear options, but not very much. It's very clear that the samurai style will benefit from heavier armor, while the ghost will use lighter armor for more mobility. They didn't really talk about the skill system or crafting system, both of which are obviously there as techniques and gear in the menu. Overall, the game is looking really solid. Maybe not groundbreaking, but a really solid open world game. Graphics seem to be really good, even though it's hard to tell from the compressed video, but there's clearly been a lot of thought put into the aesthetics of the game. I find it incredible that they include a black and white film filter for the entire game, and the amount of time they spent talking about the photo mode is, again, impressive for this type of demo. Once this comes out, expect to see a lot of GIFs of samurai battles with falling leaves all around. This seems to be like a really fun and beautiful game to explore and find everything there is to be seen. Things that are missing so far is the dialogue system and any of the side quests, which they haven't really shown, and depending on their quality could really make or break this game, I think. I hope they don't go for a generic approach, but rather for a Witcher 3 style of side quest, where every side quest is like a short story, which adds to the game not only in terms of quantity, but also in terms of quality. That should really set this apart from other games like Assassin's Creed or Shadow of Mordor. Once again, Infamous Second Son I think was really good for the PlayStation 4. The dialogue, the story was okay, but the dialogues and the animations were pretty well done, so I'm super hyped about this game. I'll be covering it as soon as it comes out on July 17th, so stay tuned for that, and subscribe if you enjoyed this video. I'm trying to expand the channel and will probably start doing a news roundup or at least some video on industry news and thoughts every Friday to talk about the events of the week. Let me know down in the comments if that's something that you would like to see, or if you have any other types of content that you would want me to do. So, that will be all, and as always, thanks for watching, and I hope I will catch you in the next one.